Hello everyone, welcome to the web engineering lecture series, and from today's onwards I am starting the topic of Java servlet. Since I am covering the course as per the theory exams of servlet, so first we will see some of the theory aspects of the servlet and then we will move towards the programming part. So in the first video we will see about the introduction to Java servlet. The advantages of servlet over CGI, it is important because sometimes in the theory exam the question is asked and where we can use the servlet. So now, what are Java servlets? Java servlets are the programs that runs on a web application server. In any programming of the website or any web application, there are two main parts. One is your client-side application that runs on the browser, and one is your server side application that runs on your web server. And Java servlets are those programs that runs on the server side of the web application. So Java servlets are the programs that runs on a web application server. It acts as a middle layer between a request from web browser, that is your client, and database application on the HTTP server. So servlets act as a middle layer between the client and the application or the database that is hosted on your HTTP server. So now let's see one simple architecture of Java servlet. Suppose this is your client. This is the client. And the client is using any web browser. So this is your client on a web browser. To interact with any server, we have one HTTP server, which we will see when we will see the programming part of servlet. So that is your HTTP server, and there can be any application or database which is hosted on the server side. So I am using the database. There can be any other application also. Now what happens is, client wants to interact with this database, but client can't access the database directly. It has to be through the HTTP server. So what happens is, client sends the request with the use of HTTP protocol to HTTP servlet. So here the protocol that is used is HTTP protocol. It is a simple protocol which is used to interact with any server over the internet. So that is your HTTP protocol. And in the middle of this HTTP server and the database application which is hosted on the server, we have what we called as the servlets program. That is why we have said that it is act as a middle layer between the request, which is this one, and the database. So this is your servlet program. So this is the servlet program. Now this HTTP server will interact with the servlet program, and then servlet program will interact with database. So that is how the servlet works over the web application. Now prior to the servlets, we use CGI, that is Common Gateway Interface, as the middle layer between HTTP server and the database. But there are certain advantages of servlet over CGI, that's why the CGI has been almost completely replaced by the use of servlets. So CGI is nothing but this is your Common Gateway Interface. And what are those advantages? We are going to see just in a bit. So the first advantage is, servlets offer better performance than CGI. Servlet offers better performance over CGI. Second is, servlets execute within the address space of web server. So the servlets executes within address space of server. Now since servlet is a technology which is based on Java. That is why servlets are platform independent, just like Java. So the third advantage is servlets are platform independent. And they are also more secure because Java offers a strong security mechanism over any other programming language. And one more advantage of servlet is we can communicate with other applications easily with the help of API like RMI. Communicate with other applications with RMI. Now RMI is remote method invocation, which is used to interact with the applications which are present on another server or another platform. So this is the introduction of Java servlet, brief architecture of servlet and the advantages of servlet. Now where we can use the servlet? There are certain uses of servlet which you need to know. First, we can use the servlet to read explicit data sent by a browser. So any data that is sent by a browser can be read easily with the help of servlet. Now with this explicit data, I mean a data that is sent via HTML form. In the later part of this tutorial series, I will show you a running program where we will create a HTML form and then we will see how to read the form values with the help of servlet. So you can read the explicit data sent by the browser. Similarly, you can read the implicit HTTP request data. You can read easily implicit HTTP request data. Sorry for the mistake. Now this includes cookies, etc. So the data that is sent by the browser implicitly, like cookies, can also be read with the help of servlet. We will see one program on this also. Then you can easily process the data before sending it to the database application or any other application. So the processing of data can be done with the help of servlets. Then once we have read the data, we can also send the data back to the browser. So you can send explicit as well as implicit data back to the browser. So you can send both implicit and explicit data to the browser. So this is the brief introduction about the Java servlet, the architecture of servlet, advantages of servlet over CGI and various uses of the servlet. In the next video, we will see the servlet life cycle. Thank you for watching the video. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel for more such tutorials. Thank you.